Good afternoon to all. Myself Vikas Mishra from Faculty of Commerce and Management. Today I am going to discuss the demand. Demand is very important topic of microeconomics. We have to discuss what do you mean by demand, what are the determinants of demand, what are the law of demands. So first we have to discuss what do you mean by demand, right? So for the demand, first we have to discuss the concept of meaning of need. Second is want. Third one is desire. Right. So these are the means very important topic related with the demand. And if you want to discuss, if you want to learn the demand, first you have to find out the meanings of all these words which I have written here. Right. So first one is need. What do you mean by need? Need basically it is related with the primary needs, we can say. Primary needs like if I'm hungry, so I need something to eat, right? And want basically it's far better from the need. If I'm consuming rice, if I'm consuming chapati, still I want some McDonald's pizza, burger, so that would be my want. Okay. And desire. It is some very big dream, you can say. If I want a big bungalow in front of Amitabh Bachchan bungalow, if I want a big luxury car, so that would be the part of desire, right? And need can be anything. Need, just I've discussed earlier, need is the primary needs. There are so many type of needs are there. If I want to deliver lecture over there on the topic of economics, so I need a classroom, I need a marker, I need a board. So this is also a part of need, right? Whether it is need, want, and desire, there is a word willingness, right? Willingness to buy plus ability to pay. Willingness to buy and ability to pay. When these both these aspects combines together, so it will create your demand, right? You can say demand, that meaning of demand is when the consumer is willing to buy of a different amount of commodity at a different level of price. So it is a part of demand. But I just concise all these things within this formula, that is willingness to buy plus ability to pay, right? So this is the part of demand. We can understand it with the help of curve. This is x-axis, this is y-axis, right? In the y-axis we can show the price of the commodity. In x-axis we can show the quantity of demand. QD is the quantity of demand, right? So price, you can just draw the bars. 1, 2, 3, 4. And quantity demanded, 1, 2, 3, 4. And here it comes, the demand curve. It slopes downward. This is called demand curve, right? It always slopes downward, just like this way. So this is the structure, this is the curve of demand, in which we can see the price which is given in y-axis, and QD, quantity of demand, which is given in x-axis. Okay. So we just have to discuss the law of demand also. What do you mean by law of demand? The law of demand is when the price, there is inverse relation between the price and quantity demanded, right? When the prices are up, yeah, we can say the maximum price is there, for the quantity demand is minimum. And when the price goes on minimum level, the demand goes on maximum level. This is the law of demand, or you can say that there is an inverse relation between price and quantity demanded, okay? And we just have to be very clear, the quantity of demand is somehow differ from demand. It is a part of demand, but we have to differentiate the quantity of demand and this demand, right? This demand or demand curve, you can say. What do you mean by quantity of demand? Quantity of demand is basically it is an individual unit, okay? Individual demand of a commodity. Individual demand means particular demand of a commodity at a particular given period of given price, right? And given period of time also. The particular price is 4 and the demand is 1. So this is a individual QD, right? And another QD is 3 and demand is 2. The third QD is 2, demand is 3. And the last QD is 1, demand is 4. So it is the, in this curve there are number of QDs, I think 4 QDs are there, okay. And with the help of 4 QD, you just have to be find or have to draw the your D, that is demand, okay. So I am just repeating my words. What do you mean by law of demand? So law of demand, there is inverse relation between price and quantity demanded. Price and quantity demanded, and just add a one important things when other things are constant, right? In other things, I've just written income, taste, preferences, expectation, etc. So we have just very careful about all these. These are the part of other things. I'm repeating my words again. There is inverse relation between price and quantity demanded. I am discussing the law of demand, right? So there is inverse relation between price and quantity demanded when other things are constant. So we have to be very sure that these things are very in a constant way. When you are learning, when you are describing the law of demand, income is should be constant, the taste should be constant, preferences should be constant, and expectations should be in a constant form, right? Extension of demand. Okay, extension of demand means increase in the demand, or we can say the we can extend with the help of we can understand with the help of this figure. I'm just going to draw it. XY. Suppose the price suppose the price is 4, this is the price, right? And this is quantity demanded. Suppose the price is 4, so demand is 1 according to the law of demand, right? And the price goes down from 4 to 1, it is obvious that demand increases, right? So it shift from here to there. So this is the part of extension of demand. It is a condition just opposite of the extension of demand, okay? We can easily understand with the help of the curves which I am going to draw it. Y, X, 0. Suppose the price is 1, demand is 4, okay? And the prices increases from 1 to 4. So demand is decreases from 4 to 1, right? So it shift in a contraction form. So this is the part of contraction of demand. You can write over there, this is contraction of demand. And the next topic is increase in demand. In increase in demand, you have to just very focused on the price. Here it is price on y-axis, and the price should be in constant form, right? The price should be in constant form. Price is 4, demand is 2, okay? And same price, demand increases from 2 to 4, okay? This is demand curve. You can write demand 1 and demand 2. It shift forward. You can say the means the another word you can use फॉरवर्ड शिफ्ट इन डिमांड कर्व, राइट। फॉरवर्ड शिफ्ट इन डिमांड कर्व इट इज अ सिनोनिम ऑफ इंक्रीज इन डिमांड इन विच प्राइस डजेंट इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज, डजेंट मीन्स चेंज, इट इज इन अ कॉन्स्टेंट मैनर बट द डिमांड goes forward or backward due to increase, due to change in the other things. I have written over there income, taste, preferences and expectation, right? The next part is decrease in demand. It is just as a, you can deal as a opposite from the increase in demand. When price is 4 and demand is 6, like this D1, and same price with change in the other factor demand shift backward from 6 to 4, okay, so it becomes D2, it shift backward from D1 to D2, so it is called decrease in the demand curve. And it happens due to change in the other things, income, taste, preferences, expectation, etc. Okay, so I've covered lots of things, extension of demand, demand curve, law of demand and all these. So this is done for today, and we'll cover another topics and more topics from next lecture. Myself Vikas Mishra from Faculty of Commerce and Management from Rama University. Okay, thank you.